Hey guys, this is John with Grain Fish Nation. Have you ever went to the lake and things just didn't go the way that you had planned? Well, that's the day I had today. Started out by getting out on the water. It was kind of mist and rain. It was lightning around a little bit, but I was real careful. Watched the lightning and the storms move on past me. And you know, I told you I've been having trouble with this 12-pound suffix line, so I put some new line on. I put some trialing big game, and man, I don't know what in the world is going on with this line these days. I have never had this much trouble with knots breaking, but I've tried different knots, Palomar knot, improved trialing knot, old G-Man knot. I even tied it today. Was finally able to keep my lures on, but today I reared back to throw a Kitech swim bait over a school of fish that was out there, and I guess I must have thrown it a little hard. But anyway, so long story short, I barely caught my rod because with all that weight behind that rod throwing that lure and the line snapped, well, the rod went right out of my hand. So I ended up diving down on the deck of the boat, and I literally caught the top eye between these two fingers of my rod. So I was able to save my rod, so that was a positive out of a negative. But then I was tinkering around up by the boat ramp, flipping some docks, and lo and behold, in pulls a little Toyota pickup, and it says Share a Lunker on the side. So I just thought I'd go up there and see what was going on. So you guys will see in the rest of this video how that went. Got to meet Nikki. She works for the Share a Lunker program, and she ended up putting some fish in the lake that were from the Lunker brood program. And then probably the best part of my day happened. These three little boys were like 9, 10 years old, and they'd been sitting over there fishing on the little pier the whole time that we were putting these little fry in the lake. And they come over and, you know, talked a little bit, and they're here for a baseball game this week for the state championship here in Mineola. Well, they came down and I asked them if they'd, you know, done any good fishing or whatever. And they said, oh yeah, we've caught a couple or whatever. So anyway, I told them, I said, well, I got something over in the boat for you guys that might help y'all out. So I went over and dug around in the boat, and I found three little rooster tails that I had bought a couple years ago when me and Stephanie went up to Oklahoma and went trout fishing, and had them in a little tackle box. So I tied each one of them a rooster tail on. But the funny part of it is I had two fire tiger ones and one white one. Well, the two older guys, they wanted the two fire tiger ones, and they were first in line, and because they didn't want the white one because it was different. So I tied the little boy a white one on. I think he was maybe a year younger. Anyway, he caught a fish first cast. I mean, it just made his day. That just made me happy, guys. So guys, stay tuned to the video and learn more about the Share a Lunker program, and watch these three young men catch some brim at the boat ramp. Thanks for joining us today here on Greenfish Nation. If you hadn't already subscribed, just go ahead and click that subscribe button down there. I'd appreciate that very much. Don't forget to turn on your notifications bell so you'll get notified whenever we upload a new video or we upload a new short. I appreciate you guys. Thank you for joining us. And don't forget to leave us a comment. Now on to the video. Guys, look who just pulled into the boat ramp. If it ain't the Share a Lunker, guys. Hey guys, it's John here with Greenfish Nation. I'm down here fishing Lake Holbrook today. I was sitting over here by the boat ramp doing a little fishing around the banks and flipping a couple docks, and lo and behold, look who showed up. It's the Share a Lunker program. They're about to put some fish here in the lake so we can have a better fishery. We're gonna talk with these folks and find out exactly how this process works. So you guys stay tuned to Greenfish Nation. Hey guys, I'm here with Miss Nikki from Texas Parks and Wildlife Share a Lunker program, and she's here at Lake Holbrook, and she just told me that they're about to put 19,000 little fry in this lake. You guys can see right there. She's checking temperature and water quality here at the lake, and she's going to make sure that the temperatures are close enough to be acclimated for these little fry to have the most success possible. So you guys stay tuned. We're going to watch her put these in the lake. And ran into Miss Nikki here.
Hi.
Miss Nikki works for the Share a Lunker program here in the state of Texas. She's here today at Lake Holbrook dropping off about 19,000 fry. Fingerlings, from this year's breeding stock to help this lake grow some bigger bass. So you mind telling us how the process works?
So when people catch like a Share a Lunker bass, so a very large bass, they're going to contact TPWD. They'll get length, weight measurements, data on where and when the fish was caught, and get the angler's name. At that point, they will contact us and we will go and we'll pick up the fish. And what we do is we take it back to one of the hatcheries where that fish is spawned with another Share a Lunker bass, I believe.
What Nikki's doing right now is she's checked the water quality of the lake here, the temperature. What other levels are you checking?
Dissolved oxygen.
Dissolved oxygen, okay. And she's trying to match it with the tank. Actually, the tank matched to the lake. So we've been putting a little bit of water in there with a pump and some buckets to try to acclimate the fish just like you would in the home aquarium, right?
Yeah, we temper them so that we can get those conditions similar enough that there's not additional stress and shock for those fish once they're in the lake.
Well, that's awesome. Well, guys, here in a couple years, we'll have some better fish here in the lake. Guys, I don't know if you can see these little bass in here, but I'm not sure how clear the picture is going to be with the glare on the water, but they've already got the stripe on their side. They already speckle on their back. And they're ready to start eating your baits before you know it. I think that one's going to be a 13 pounder. He's already time and half the size of the others. All right, guys, that's what a few thousand little fry. It's fry, right?
Fingerlings
at this point look like. We're gonna test a few out and see how they do. So this is the test batch to see if the water is acclimated temperature-wise good enough. I'm here in just a couple minutes, guys. Let's see what 19,000 little fry looks like. All right, guys, Miss Nikki's gonna back up here. We're gonna try to get this pipe a little closer to the water so we can let these fish go. All right, guys, the pipe was a little too far out of the water for Miss Nikki's comfort, so we're gonna watch her net these 19,000 fry fingerlings. Dadgummit, I messed it up again. Fingerlings into the water. Look at them go. They're on their way to go be in big bass. Good when you see all of them swimming off. Those are baby bass, so when you guys get my age, y'all have fish in here to catch. Guys, that's what it looks like when the Share a Lunker program comes to town and drops off a few future lunkers for you. Miss Nikki, we appreciate you coming out here today and doing this for our lakes.
Well, I'm so glad
and all our future
fishermen.
Chance.
It's It's my pleasure.
Yeah, she's got a long drive home, guys, so we're going to let her go. You be safe going home, and maybe we'll see you around again soon.
Well, thank you.
All right.
Hope to hear you guys catching some of these big lunkers.
Hey, guys, I'm down here at the lake. Just finished up with the Share a Lunker program, and three young boys over here fishing off the dock, fishing for some bream, and not doing a whole lot of good, but y'all come here, guys. What's y'all's names?
Max, Caleb, and Brody.
So which one of you is Max?
I'm Max.
All right, and then Caleb?
Me.
Which one?
Me.
Okay, and then Brody, you're in the sunglasses, right? Okay. So these guys are down here enjoying a week of championship baseball. They're playing here in, I guess, Mineola?
Yeah.
At the state tournament. Anyway, I got them some lures here. I don't have any bobbers. I thought I did, but we're going to tie them one of these rooster tails on, and we'll see what they can catch. So you guys hang in there. All right, guys, we got them young men fixed up. Got them a rooster tail apiece, so maybe they can catch some fish. We'll see. All right, tell me about your fish there, bud.
First cast, I passed it right off the
dock. Awesome, on a white rooster tail. Nobody else wanted a white. White rooster tail, he got a fish on the first cast, guys. What do y'all think about that? We'll see if he can get another one here, guys. All right, guys, Max got him a little brim on the little fire tiger rooster tail. Show us there, Max. Yeah. Max, Brody, Caleb, right? All right, guys. Well, this is a good way to spend the summer, ain't it?